So if you've watched our webcams here at Blue Spring, you may have noticed manatees covered in fish. And a lot of people think those manatees are getting a spa treatment. But what's really going on? So today I'm here with Dr. Missy Gibbs from Stetson University. And what kind of fish are these?
These are an armored catfish. Their species is Pterygoplichthys disjunctivus. And a lot of people call them plecos and have them in their fish tanks. And that's actually how they've gotten into the Florida waters, and they've become pretty much a big invasive problem. And they are an invasive species, and they also are exotic. Exotic just means that they're not from Florida. But invasive means that they have some characteristics that make them very good at taking over in their new habitat. So these fish grow really fast. So they grow about 10 centimeters every year and live to be about 5. And they reproduce like crazy. So a single female might lay 30,000 eggs every summer. And that by itself might not seem like that big a deal to a fish biologist, but these fish also will guard their nests. So the males will dig burrows into the banks of rivers and maybe the spring run as well, and the female will lay her eggs there. The male will guard them, and that means that almost all of those eggs are going to hatch. So they've got a big advantage over most other native fish in our area.
So what effects do these catfish have on the manatees?
So some people think that the catfish are hurting the manatees when they're crawling all over them. But really what they're doing is they're grazing the algae off of their skin. So they've got very soft, kind of bristly mouths, and they're just kind of going all over them getting the algae, but it seems to annoy the manatees. So that's what we're concerned about, is how much disturbance the manatees are experiencing and what effect that has on their behavior, especially in the winter time.
Especially when they're here to rest and conserve energy, and manatees have these really tiny hairs that are very, very sensitive, so those fish are probably pretty annoying.
I think they are, and when you see some manatees that can have upwards of 40 catfish on them all at the same time, that's a lot. The manatee moves and tries to get them off, and the catfish come off like flies and then settle back down again. And the manatees are just a lot more active when they have the catfish on them.
So it's not necessarily hurting them, but it's almost like a mosquito, like you're trying to go to sleep and you have this mosquito buzzing around you.
Exactly. And you might notice when you look at the spring run that there really are, other than algae, there aren't any plants that are in the water. There's not anything for the manatees to eat. And so the manatees, if they're getting, you know, annoyed by catfish, are burning more calories in the spring run and have to go out and feed in the river more often. And that's where the big danger comes for the manatees.
So how did these catfish that are obviously not native to Florida, how did they end up in Blue Spring?
Well, people get them to eat algae off the sides of their fish tanks, and they get them when they're really little. But these fish get up to about 50 centimeters long, or about 2 feet long. And so when they get too big, or people get tired of them, they let them go. People tend to want to let things go into the wild rather than euthanize them or give them to somebody else with an aquarium. And unfortunately, this is a species that does very well in the Florida ecosystem, and they've really thrived.
So is there any way to sort of eradicate these catfish, like spearfishing, for example?
Yeah, so we can't eradicate them, but we can remove some of them. And so one of the things that we do under permits from the Department of Environmental Protection is that we remove some exotics from the spring run. And so we go out spearfishing, we collect fish. Some of the fish will be used for research, and others are just going to be removed from the spring run itself. And one of the really interesting results of this is that the number of catfish we see during the daytime has gone down. I think that they have figured out that there is fishing going on, and so they go out and spend most of their time in the river. They come in at night still, but at least during the daytime it might be a little bit more pleasant for the manatees.
Some pretty smart fish there. Well, that's pretty eye-opening, and I think it really shows that we shouldn't be releasing anything out into the natural environment that's not native, because it can become really invasive and then potentially hurt the native species.